Good evening and welcome to episode number 127. We are still here in Stonebear Hold, and if I remember correctly, our plan was to go do that little combat thing. So yeah, let's go do that. There's also a lot of other stuff we can do in this area. But while we're here, let's win the favor of the gods and hopefully the Avar as well. Talk to that guy already. Not sure if this is going to be one-on-one combat or 4v-something combat. Kind of 1v1 just for something different, but as long as it's a challenge, team fights could be interesting as well.
Can we begin this trial of Hakkon?
We need an offering from you first.
Oh, the requisition. Right.
Farewell.
Safe journeys.
How quickly we forget. Alright, let's go to one of our campsites then. Let's just go to this one. And then we'll hopefully make one of those requisitions, the offerings, and come back. It's a nice way to tie in the requisition system, I guess. It makes sense, but it's kind of annoying too. An offering. Very easy to make. Should we make more than one? Can we make more than one? We cannot. We can do this, though. Not that it really matters at all at this point, but why not? Alright, we're gonna fast travel back there. I do want to get to those two missions, hopefully today, but first things first. Once again, back up the cliffs. Don't have a ton of time to play today, but I think we can get in a good two episodes. And hopefully get a lot done in this zone. Not sure what that means. The wind seems colder than it should. Are you implying something by that?
Well met.
The Inquisition has brought an offering to enter your trials.
Yes! Oh, this will be a fight to remember.
I sure hope so.
I mean, enter the arena grounds. Hakkon's trials await.
I'm ready to begin Hakkon's trials.
Excellent. Step into the grounds.
Oh, I guess I have to manually go there.
Farewell.
Safe journeys.
All right, will do. I believe the entrance was down here. There we go. Let's do it. Survive the trial, not win. Well, that's interesting. Are potions like disabled? Looks like they are. Huh. Definitely want to keep barriers up then. Oh, it's disabled because I'm at full health. Right. Target that guy. Target that guy. Not that guy. Barriers. I'm targeting everybody but... Nope, I had him. Noted. I'm looking for the target markers from Skotor, which are above the health bar and not below the health bar like they are in this game. Well, that's right. Dorian's here. He's reanimated one of them to fight for us. But they're not really dead, so I don't know how they're... Oh, they're kind of just sitting there. That's interesting. Or maybe they're... No, that one actually was reanimated. Alright, round two, I guess. Yep, so we're basically facing lots of Avar. Speaking of them, they do less damage. That was pretty good. Kill this one here. Get another barrier up. I'm going to try to save my Rift Magic for one of the tougher rounds. Hopefully there are tougher rounds. Some kind of buff going on right now from one of my allies. Oh, Varric's in trouble. Where is he? Oh, is that guy? I That should be all of them. Here's round three. Try to get my combo going early. Get another barrier. Oh, thank you, Dorian. Save me a barrier there. I'm gonna use one now, though. Well, I meant to use one at least. Oh, the chieftain. That's a chieftain or champion. And that's one over there too, isn't it? Nope. Target that guy. Target that guy. Yes. Do a chain lightning because they're all grouped up like that. Good knockback. Barrier. Fire mine, but he might. Oh, there's two of them, okay. In that case, let's put out a Mark of the Rift and some more fire damage. Use a barrier. Let's buff our next attack. He got his guard back up. With almost dead though. Yay. Alright. Was that it or was there gonna be more? I hope there was more because I didn't save or I did save my Mark of the Rift.
Ha, what a fight that maneuver would be. Well, you saw well fought, Inquisitor.
Farewell.
Safe journeys.
Yep, that might be it for this quest. Well, I don't know. I still see a... What's that new quest there? Wasn't bad for a small little quest. Kind of hope there'd be more to it, but... It was good for what it was. Better not to draw it out too long. Can I actually enter for more combat, though? Maybe you can do it repetitively? Are you gonna fight me? Let's see. Yeah, this is okay. That must be the quest then. Oops, didn't mean to do that. I don't know, do we get more favor for doing this a second time? I'm gonna guess no, but let's try just in case. We don't really need the XP, but... It doesn't take very long, so we might as well do it. That's it for wave one. It's actually not a bad idea to put my fire mine down ahead of time. I assume it stays there in between rounds. Yes, it does. Although I'm actually going to move it closer now. I should put it right in front of the gate for round three. That'd be the smart thing to do. I do kind of miss the giant AoE spells of the first Dragon Age game. All these explosions are cool, but having just an inferno casted there, I do kind of miss that. And that's round two. Alright, let's go ahead and use Mark of the Abyss for these guys. Oh, I forgot to lay down my fire mine. Here we go. Pull a hole in the fade. I feel like that's kind of overkill for... Friendly fight though. Oh, they didn't blow up my mine. Do the champions spawn later or did we already kill them instantaneously? Not much of a threat, but he does have a lot of health. Alright. Well, the Mark of the Rift definitely made that easy. Oh, is there a fourth round? There were only three last time, right? Did I lose count? I'm pretty sure they were only a little late on that barrier we were in. Alright, maybe there were four rounds. I thought I remember there being three. Guess I should save my mark for this one, oh well. Not much harder than the last wave. Oh, that guy has a bit of health left. Alright, all done. Let's see if we get some more favor. No, it's not done. So this must have bonus rounds because you come back in here. How you face Nugs? Oh, I don't want to kill the Nugs because we have to, though. I'll make it quick. I'll have boiled Nug tonight, I guess. Not what I was expecting. Guess the Arena Master is a bit of a jokester. Oh, there's more though. I'm gonna do my own barrier this time. Oh, I didn't even mean to do that, but I'm glad I did that. I was gonna put it down anyway. Wherever. This might even just go on forever. Do you get XP for these guys? I haven't really been paying attention to it. Not that I care. Which is probably why I haven't been paying attention. Oh, he's line of sighting me. Line of sight that. Not a bad place to leave my,
Dorian, I would prefer if you stopped referring to me as that hairy lummox.
When did I do that?
The tavern, the smithy, the servants. You said it to the gate guards as we left Skyhold.
That does sound funny.
Oh. Bad, I can do it again, though, because I had Flashpoint. The one left. Alright, I'm gonna do one or two more rounds, then I'm just gonna assume it's infinite, and I guess try to leave. Can I even? Yeah, I can leave. Yeah, it seems like it repeats. We already almost have enough for Mark of the Abyss, though. That's actually, that is a good way to charge your focus ability. Whoa, that guy is right in front of me. Barrier. Is that it? No. Can't tap target to him for some reason. Alright. This will be the last one. I think this is back to the normal guys. Now I do see a champion there. Let's see if we can lure them onto that fire mine. All the fire. Getting attacked though. Oh, Oh, I used barrier twice in a row. Fire mine down. Pop to that guy. Alright, that should be it. And after this one, we're gonna leave the arena, because apparently this goes on forever. It is a nice way to practice and to, enter arena. Oh, because... What? I thought I clicked on that door. Am I stuck? I guess I can quick travel. Can I go out the other side, maybe? I don't know, because every time I'm confused. Either I'm missing something very obvious, or maybe not so obvious, or the game is bugged. Sending these people at me again and again and again. I don't know how I'm supposed to exit the arena clicking on that door. Just brings me back into the next fight. See, every time I kill them all, I'm right back here. This is the way out. I can tell through the gate there, but every time I click it, it puts me right back where I was. And that just resets the fight. Well, way to go, Bioware. You permanently locked people inside of this arena, fighting endless waves of mobs for all eternity. Waves of mobs. I'll try their gate, otherwise I'm gonna have to either quick travel or reload. But really, that's just that's a dumb oversight. How did you not... Like, at some point, they had to actually program in what happens when you kill them all. Repeat infinitely. Should not have been an option. That's a dead end anyway. It's not a bad bug as far as bugs go, but it's just kind of makes you shake your head. Can I jump off the cliff? And I'm assuming that exclamation point is for this one. Because I don't see anything else around here that could possibly be a quest. Alright, we're out of combat. We can't quick travel in the arena. Apparently. Nope. Okay. Well, where's my last quick load, I guess? Let's find out. So, no, don't go back and do the arena a second time. Did we do the quest? That looks like we did. I think I quicksaved it a second time. Yeah, alright, that was good at least, so... We didn't really lose anything, but... Oh, I didn't use my focus ability, so I guess I actually gained something then. Oh well, still a stupid bug, but not game-breaking. Unless you save your only save inside of there. Then it's game-breaking, but... So you should always do different saves. Never, ever, ever overwrite all your saves. Alright, well that was that quest. I don't know how else we help their favor. I guess just by going around and doing some of these other quests. What's over here? Oh, the hold beast. Alright, let's start by heading over this way, because we haven't been over here yet. And can we get over here this way? I think there's a path over here. Sure looks like it. But there isn't. Just the bleachers. Alright. Well, back through the canyon it is then. And then from there we will head to the northern parts of this land, and then we'll eventually make our way back down south to go to that island. Did I miss it? No, it's down one more series of steps. I'm kind of worried that I'm going to explore this entire place, and then the main quest is going to still have me going back and forth across the place anyway. Like, they might do it that way to encourage people to explore, but not the end of the world if that's the case. We'll just go through and do the main quest back to back to back then. Which could be fun. Regardless, we have found a new area of the map. Well, I don't know. We've been here, but we haven't been too much further from here. Let's take the high road. Always take the high road. Besides, it's prettier up here. Some kind of ruin in the distance. I know I said this before, but they did a really good job with this zone. There's nothing like it's easy to make like a really cool mountainous zone or lush jungle zone. This is just kind of a normal place. It just looks really, really good. It's kind of like an island coast, but... Alright, the Astrorium is over here. It's definitely good that we went up then. What is that thing? Giant plant? Fortress gates. Is this the fortress where the Jaws of Hakkon live? Ah, it's just a giant plant. Interesting. Alright, not quite sure how to get to the Astrorium. Hoping it's through here. And not like... I don't know. Up and over a jump or something. Yep, here it is. The last one in the zone. Maybe the last one in the game, but I hope not. I'd be okay if all the DLC added like a zone and a quest inside of it, but I kind of like the idea of one of them being more story-driven as well. My guess is maybe... Well, I don't know. Maybe the next one, the Descent, adds a Deep Roads Expedition zone? Okay, so this is 3. Where are we headed? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Not there. No, okay, this is 4. This is 4, okay. Right. My theory still holds. This one is 3, so that'll be our final guy. I don't know what this constellation is supposed to be, though. The triangles. The scribe. I bet it's a scribe. Looks like a guy writing at a desk, doesn't it? There's his legs, and he's like leaning over, writing it like a tablet of some sort. That's going to be my guess. That or like a carco on a rock. One of the two. But yeah, my guess is this is going to be the scribe. Did I mess up? No, I just forgot a line. It's the mountain, of course. Not a scribe. I wish you could go back and see it again with just the initial design. I guess I can buy that, but I still think it looked more like a scribe. Belenos. Korth, the mountain father, kept his throne at the peak of the mountain Belenos, which lay at the center of the world and was so lofty that from it he could see all the corners of the earth and sky. So it's kind of like their version of Olympus. Over time, bold young Avar would challenge each other to scale the mountain of the gods. At first, Korth found this amusing and delayed in the valor of their failed attempts to enter his hold. Then Sindri Skybreaker, boldest of the heroes, succeeded in climbing to the summit and stood in the hall of the Mountain Father in the flesh. Korth, being a good sport, gave Sindri a hero's welcome, and the mortal returned to the Frostbacks with tales of the Feast of the Gods and gifts from Korth. And soon more and more heroes were barging into the hall of the Mountain Father, demanding to be showered with honors. Korth grew weary of throwing banquets, and the other gods began to fear his temper. So this is... Compare the reaction of Korth versus the Maker. Korth is, like, you know, begrudging eventually, but he's, you know, he's jolly about it. Like, okay, you won my challenge. The Maker, meanwhile, no, I cast you down. Get out of my throne room. I'm going to put a curse upon the entire world because you decided to enter my little city here. So it's also kind of interesting to think, too, that this might be... One myth might have grown from the other because they are similar in some ways. Anyway... Korth spoke to the Lady of the Skies and lifted Belenus from the earth into her realm, which could not be reached even by the most intrepid climber, and there he dwells in peace. I like that story. It's kind of like he's like a grumpy old man, tired of the kids on his lawn, on his mountain. So I assume we now have the location of a, what do you call it? A cache of some sort? Not there. Yep, there it is. Cool. We'll head there eventually. Let's go get this rift first. There does seem to be a lot we haven't explored over here. And as we can tell by the region count, we haven't explored the whole map yet. Not by quite a bit. All right, so these are some impressive fortress gates. They almost worthy of Mordor. All right, just a landmark on the bridge, probably. There's the Fade Rift up there. We'll grab that in 1 second. Once we claim this little bridge for the Inquisition. Yay us. Remains frozen. Does it remain frozen? I don't really see any ice. Like I said, thawed since then. Oh, that maybe meant the gate, not the bridge. Huh. Kind of wish I'd read that now. A frozen bridge isn't that interesting. A frozen gate, a little more so, since it was obviously placed there by magic. So the jaws of Hakkon have mages then, not surprising. Hey guys. Call the pirate. Whoa. Saved by the amulet. Why is my... Oh, because I'm in AoE mode. See, why is my health not going up? Put a fire mine up here. Interesting place to put a rift. I like it. Fear demons. They could be tough. It's still no match for the Inquisition. Oh, rage demons. Let's see some lightning attacks then. Dispel you guys. Very nice. Let's get a barrier on me too. Put down a fire mine, even though it won't do much to those three. Lots of. Oh, that's Dorian's lightning. You know what? Let's switch to Dorian for a second. Oh, it's already. Never mind. Time to close it. What was that? Is that just Varric's stomach growling? A little hungry? Gotta remember to use their focus abilities as well. Most of them are fully charged. And we receive. Alright, that was a spider. Is there actually loot from this rift? Or is it down in the courtyard there? I'm afraid to jump down there, because knowing Bioware, there might not be a way back up. But no, it looks like there is. It's a pretty bird. Bird of paradise. Haven't seen one up close yet. Alright, let's see if there's any loot down there. Because normally the rifts drop really good loot. There is, yay. Figurine of Andraste on the pyre. I have one of those on the end of my staff. Another really cool dagger. With a pop a rune in there and give it to Cole. You guys took the boring way here. Okay, I see a question mark. Let's head over there. I think this is away from the gates though, right? Yeah, maybe we should go visit the gate while we're here. There's another rift over there. Let's go back over this way. Take a closer look at the gate. I'm sure we can't go inside quite yet. I'm okay with that. Some things you should only be able to do once you advance the main quest. This way. So that was just like a little outpost up there. The real fort is back here. We'll probably get shot by arrows from above or ice balls or something, but let's see.
Does this say overcompensating to anyone else?
They certainly don't want anybody getting through. What happens when they have to leave, though? They just melt it, or do they probably have a secret entrance somewhere. That would at least be my guess. That's a cool idea, though, that they keep the gate eternally frozen. I mean, with how common fire magic is, you think you could just burn through it. I'm going to assume it's like some kind of special magical ice. Because because I'm not in combat, my mana is generating faster than I can actually use this. That's kind of cool. Yeah, not making any progress. It'd be really cool if you actually could, if you were a good fire mage. But that would kind of break the plot. Is it like a tunnel up there or something? Because it's where they stand to reapply the ice. Anyway, cool idea, but we'll have to come back there later. Abandoned jail. Alright, let's go see what that's about. I guess there's not a landmark there, because I didn't see a landmark symbol. Oh. These, they are. Hey guys. A patrol, I suppose. There we go. Fire may not work on the ice wall, but it works on these guys. And some lightning for good measure. You couldn't have barriered me. I had to do it myself. Oh, die already, come on. There's a ton of health. There we go. And that poor little Tusket. Okay. That took longer than it should have. Is he still alive? Oh, there's two of them, okay. All the fire. Wait, is this the right way? Kinda. You know what, let's go this way though. Even if it doesn't lead right towards the jail, because I kinda wanna see what's over here. There's gotta be something over here if there's a path. It also occurred to me we have not found a dragon yet, if there are any dragons in this zone. I kinda feel like they wouldn't add a whole other zone without adding a dragon. In fact, I'm pretty sure I read like one of like the loot tables or the recipe tables that like drops from a dragon in the DLC. So I know one of the DLCs at least has a dragon. I thought it was this one. Minor spoilers, but not really. Yeah, 15 out of 22. There's still a lot to explore. It's a nice big zone. It's almost as big as the Hinterlands. This place is huge. Definitely worth the 10 bucks or whatever it cost. Although really it's worth, well, I don't know. How much is the base game these days? Probably like $20. And you can buy probably, what, 60 for the Game of the Year edition? So it's probably actually more expensive in that vein, but still, the original game was $60, and so is the Game of the Year edition, so I don't feel bad buying it. I wonder if that's the case, though. Could you buy the regular edition and the DLC separately still, and then get it cheaper that way? I doubt it. I mean, you get all the extra bonus DLC as well, which is kind of nice, but like the Quinari armor and the spoils of the Avar. Okay. That's gotta hurt. Ah, there's a Deft Hands place. I assume it's a Deft Hands place and not just a... Oh, I didn't mean to fall yet. Am I gonna die?
Look at the ground.
I'm getting closer to it every second.
Perhaps the Avar bear. If the bear's not dead, it must be nearby.
Alright, well, that's not what we were really looking for, but while we're in the area, I guess we might as well. Let's set that as active. Is the door up there? Probably. Yeah, sorry, Varric. Hang in there. I'll get you to unlock that eventually. I'm exactly where I don't want to be. Oh, there we go. But is this the right way? I don't think so. How do you get back up there? Let's try the cave. Bears like caves, right? It's an old stereotype, but probably for a reason. The cave is, I want to say, below me? Well, we can't go back up, so we might as well go down. We could go down the slow way over there, but you know me. We still have 6 potions left. We're fine. What is that? Oh, Philandris. I might need that. Ooh, Balefire. Haven't seen that in a while. Oh, this is the abandoned jail. Oh, okay, cool. So I didn't miss it. And what do you know? There are some Hakkonites in here. Not so abandoned after all, I see. Maybe it's just not used as a jail anymore? Whoa, I saw that coming, but not really anything I could have done against it in that span of time. That backstab. Good thing I have my amulet. That's all I gotta say. Oh, is somebody still alive? Yeah. That's our guy, right? Yeah. Alright, well. We can have Varric unlock this cell. See what we can find. Some notes. Mysteries of the Frostback. Long ago, they would have been under the water until the Tevinter drained much of Swamp Kuldstaten to build this prison. Why make a jail so remote? For prisoners they wish to hide. Oh, so this is their Guantanamo Bay, essentially. Tevinter has made war on Orlais many times, but I now believe there is also a secret war between them that the common people are not allowed to see. This prison is a remainder of the secret war that continues in our time. Oh, I like secret wars. I speak of Orlais' attempts to rouse the Snake Kings of the Earth against Tevinter's alliance with the Moon Men. This one might be bullshit, though. This is explained in Sir Yeek's pamphlets, of which I have read many, which explain things such as why the snake appears in Tevinter's drawings and how the Snake Kings came to exist. Crystals. Did Moon Men have their Tevinter allies keep the reptilian ones here so they could interrogate them at their leisure? None can say, but I say yes, as that would fit my theories. Well, what better reason is there to believe something than that it fits your theories? Wonder if the Augur believes in these theories. Didn't he have these writings on his... No, the storekeeper. Maybe they are related. Either as part of the plot or just as, you know, a little Easter egg. But I'm pretty sure those were the same markings. I could easily see a dev like making the markings for like this area and then being like, you know what, let's put it in there as kind of a joke that one of the villagers is also into these Barry, conspiracy theories.
When you were at the Winter Palace, did you meet Celine's handmaidens?
The ones that finish each other's sentences?
Oh, yes, them, I yeah. Did.
They were asking me about you. Personal things.
How personal?
Something about your chest hair and whether you were currently involved with anyone.
Huh. Creepy.
He says that, but what is he really? Whoa. Hey, we found the bear! You're free, bear. The Hakkonites imprisoned you. Why didn't just kill you? I'm not really sure. Oh, I love you too. Now go be free and get out of that. Is there like a rain cloud following her, like cartoons? That's what it looks like. Or are we just blocking your path? We're probably just blocking your path. Alright, well. Let's unlock the other cells. There she goes. I already freed you. You're already free. You can go now. Good. Well, if the bear's gonna follow me, it's gonna be a very long way back to the village. I hate escort quests. I assume the bear can't die, though, because if it could, then it would have killed it. So is this one of those, like, a ruin by the same people who made the pyramids? I thought they said the Tevinters made this, though. There's grenade belts for those of you who need grenades, or who use grenades. I haven't really gotten into it, although I saw a video of one of the fights, one of the dragon fights, I think, and the somebody was using the Jar of Bees grenade. It did look pretty cool. Maybe I should make some of those. Ooh, there you go. Scepter of Razakal. Razakal was one of the old gods, I'm pretty positive. I think he's like, or he's, he might be one of the ones we haven't found yet, like the old god of mystery or something, or chaos is, I think, Zazakiel or something like that. I think he is the old god of mystery, or the knight, one of the two. Anyway, It's an empty rune, but you could put a rune in it, obviously. Let's, I'm gonna stick with my staff, but let's try it out, see what it looks like, and maybe we'll give it to... Oh, I don't like that one at all. I like the blade, but... That's... I wish it looked more like the little icon did. That's actually kind of a cool staff design. That's been in all three games, I'm pretty sure. This one is kind of just like... It looks like a spider, like, just made a cocoon, or... I know spiders don't make cocoons, but... That's it. It reminds me of, like, the bagworms that make their cocoons, like, in trees. They look kind of like that. Just this odd shape. Anyway, mine is a lot better. It looks like even with an upgraded thing, it would probably still be better. Let's see. Well, no, actually, that one will be slightly better. It is a higher level. Mine's made with dragon bone, though. I guess this one is also made, quote-unquote, with tier 4. All right, so it would be slightly better. At least in terms of damage, if it had the same rune mine did. You could probably give it a better blade, too. But I think overall, mine's still going to be the way to go, because it's hard to beat 38% attack. That one is 20 less. Oops. I think I'm probably going to let Dorian keep his staff as well. Yeah. Actually, his staff is better than mine, I'm pretty sure. Vivian could upgrade hers. It would probably be unequivocally better than hers, but oh, we unlocked that one already. But it doesn't really seem like the kind of staff Vivian would use. Alright, so I guess once I get out of the cave, then he's freed. That, or we'll be about to be confronted by an NPC. Or multiple NPCs. Stay away from my bear. Oh, they were saving it for a sacrifice. That makes sense. Use one of my good potions here. Just, you know what I'm gonna... Nah. Should use my Mark of the Rift, but... Didn't think of it. Kind of pointless to use it now. Yay, the bear is free. Go eat and be merry. I guess there's probably a veil rating in there somewhere that I missed, but I don't really care that much. Alright, so let's head up here next and find Colette. Of course, easier said than done. How do we get up there? Ah, it's a creepy statue. That's cool. I like there are creepy statues in the game, because that means somebody built them. And probably somebody interesting.
Can it be so dark?
Well, it's called there's sunlight, then there's lots of trees, and then there's us. That's how that works. Yeah, I was getting higher, but I guess we have no way to go but down. Is that an invisible wall? No, I can keep going this way. Alright, onward then. And downward. Every time I get a little bit higher, we have to jump back down. Alright, here we go. It's the source of the swamps, I guess. Wonder, does this connect back to that other waterfall we saw? Well, I guess the frozen waterfall wasn't really a waterfall, because it wasn't like in a river or anything. It was just kind of there. Oh, this is just one of the branches. Okay, so it starts... Oh, so it comes... So the rivers drain into the swamps from the mountain, and then I guess it drains... I don't know. Somewhere. Not sure how much thought Bioware put into the drainage system of Vrildon. The hydrology, as they call it. Alright, so we need to go... That's our cache up there. Let's head up this way. That might get us to our goal a little more quickly by the looks of it. According to our minimap there. I'm going to go a little bit long again just because I don't have time for 3 short episodes, but I do have time for 2 long episodes, if that makes sense. So I'll do 2 long episodes. To get as much time as I can. And then, as usual, get to bed later than I probably should. Almost there. Wow, that is quite a, even with some of the stuff isn't rendered, obviously, because it's too far away. And the game would be really slow if it did that, but alright. I was going to not take any more screenshots, but I gotta take one here. That is cool. All the smoke in the background. Alright, good enough. I can see my camp from up here. I can see some houses at least. Oh, that's, I remember seeing houses a while back. I don't remember whose they belong to, though. Some old ruins to venture by the looks of it. I don't know what this does. Let's pull it. What could go wrong?
That wasn't it.
But what is it? And by that I mean, what is it? Guess we'll keep searching. For it. Whatever it may be. Okay, so we're kind of getting away from where we need to go. Look at the sun going through the plants. That's so cool. I hear... Hakkonites. Oh, that's the Energize. It's an Embrium. Is that them? No. That's a plant. That looks like a jumping puzzle over there. Oh, they're way down there, I see. So that's the Astrorian cache. Colette is also around here, but... where? In that cave, maybe? The cave is beneath... well, no, it looks like she's up there on that hill. I'm not really sure how to get up that hill again. Was there a path that led up there? Oh, can I go up? Oh, that's cool. Oh, this is our... okay, we've actually been here. This is one of our camps. Alright, let's go see what's in the Astroriums. And then we'll go up the camp. And that should take us high enough to find Colette. Wasn't Colette in, like... wasn't that, like, Sweeney Todd's daughter in Sweeney Todd? Colette? Oh, no, in, Les Mis. Wasn't that Colette? Something like that? Oh, I'm really nervous. I'm gonna fall. We made it. Alright, quick save, because I hate these kind of puzzles. Oh, you pushed me, Blackwall! God damn you! You pushed me! I have it on video, too. I'm gonna show it to the police. Alright, I'm also gonna quick load it, because... I don't want to walk all the way back up there. That's not the quick load button. That's the quick load button. I was literally standing there and he moved forward and my character moved. Alright. Everyone please stay back. No, don't! No. You know what, Black Wolf? For that, you're doing it. Yeah, you're already halfway over. I don't feel like he's as nimble as Leovara, but... you know, I don't even care at this point. And for that, I got 200 gold. Nice little monument to alcohol here? Is that what that is? I guess. Alright, that was not the Astroriums, though. The Astroriums are down here. Whee! You lose guard if you fall, I didn't know that. He'll be alright, though. He's tanky. I am glad we're near a camp, though, because we actually are getting low on potions. Mainly from falling. I can defeat pretty much any enemy in the game now, but I can't defeat cliffs. Is there no other loot in here? Just that one piece? Alright, better be something good. Let's see what solving the Zestoriums has earned us. Hakkon's Honor, a very nice sword. And a masterwork jagged battle axe schematic. Alright, well, let's see. Can you use that? It's actually not. I guess because it has a frost rune. Mine has a master. No, they're the same in terms of runes. It's more damage, but less DPS. I guess axes are just faster weapons. Lots of armor pen. Some heal on kill. Stagger on hit. I'm gonna. What does it look like? Does it look cool? If it looks cool, I'll use it. Oh yeah, it's like an icicle. It's kind of cool, I guess. Let's use it. Something different. Blackwell used Blackwell's Honor for quite a bit. Doesn't really match the rest of his armor, but it is kind of cool looking. It'd be nice for like Vivian as like a knight enchanter, but they can't use actual swords, just ethereal swords. Alright, well, I think it's probably a pretty good stopping point then. Let's end this episode here, and when I come back in a few minutes, we will go find Colette, maybe close that portal, wander around here, and if we have time, head down to the coast. I'll see you guys then.